I'm Rachel, and I was hoping to come to you actually a little bit earlier during last weekend with a reading update, but I haven't been moving as fast as I one would like to with my December TBR. I'm slowly getting through it, but I'm not quite there yet. And I wasn't sure what to do about filming anything, but Steve Donoghue just tagged me in a video, so I thought, I don't think I'm at a place yet to talk about what I'm reading. I'm hoping to get a little more done first in that arena. But I'll rejoin BookTube with a tag. So, this is the YouTube Confessions tag, which I believe Ben Sanders revived from the dead recently. So I'll link to Steve and Ben's channels down below. So I have them all written out here on my phone. Number one, how many hours a week do you spend editing and filming? I've never actually timed myself on any of this, so I'm kind of guesstimating, but usually my filming takes between 15 minutes to half an hour. Like, that's the entirety of the filming. And I do editing. I'm one of those jump cutters because I have awkward silences and stumbling over words and stuff like that in my videos. And often it goes down to being half the length of what I filmed, or maybe a little bit over half the length. Sometimes I only skim a few minutes, but so I guess all in all it takes about a couple of hours per film of filming and editing. Question two is, are you a spender or a saver? And I guess the two big things for BookTube about this are what you spend on your book hauls, which is probably my biggest source of spending, although it's not just for BookTube. I buy the books also to read them, although I do talk about them in hauls and in wrap-ups and that sort of thing. But for BookTube specifically, the only thing that I've really bought specifically for BookTube videos is this camera that I'm using right now. And I went for the more cheap model. I went for a $200 camera and found it rather useful, especially for vlogging, for the vlogs that I did all throughout November. And it was great to be able to have this available to me to be able to take out into the world. And I could probably learn how to do it on my phone, but I find this little camera rather easy and convenient. Question three is, who is your YouTube crush? Well, I don't want to make anyone jealous. I think I'm going to go with John Green's Crash Course Literature videos, mostly because he just came out with some new ones recently, and I was watching them over the weekend. And I'm a bit iffy on John Green's writing. I kind of enjoy the his style of quirk, although it has its limitations. But I do think as a critic, as a literature critic, and particularly in how these videos are produced, he has a lot of charm and interesting things to say. Question four is, who are your favorite YouTubers? And much like Steve, I really like everyone I've subscribed to. And one of my biggest things is that I subscribe to 50 people, and I know that's like a drop in the bucket of BookTube. I even sometimes look for videos from people that I don't subscribe to, and I'm not sure exactly why I don't subscribe to them, even though I watch their videos sometimes. I think the real reason is that I've had it in my head that I want to watch the majority of the videos that people put out, and I'm sort of at my limit here with the amount of time I have, given that I also have to work and hopefully do some reading and some writing and stuff like that. And I've been thinking about actually making this a discussion video or question, but I could just do it here is see what you guys have to say about it, because I know a lot of you are subscribed to a whole lot more than 50 people. So I'm curious what your how you justified how much you watched. I'm assuming you can't watch everything. I just don't think it's possible. I think you could watch every TV show ever made before you can watch everything BookTube has produced. So do you pick and choose? Is it like, oh, I only ever watch book hauls, or is it more of a I'll watch what I can, what I see on my feed, and just not watch whatever I can't watch. Even I mean, I guess that's what I'm thinking of now. Like, maybe I should subscribe to more people and just watch what I can when it comes up. And even if that means not being able to see the majority of videos out there, I get an eclectic, diverse taste of what BookTube has to offer, because there are a lot of great people on here. And so I'm only going to highlight a few, but I really like a whole lot of people on here. So I'll start with the two people who introduced me to BookTube, I mean, indirectly through their videos. I just love their styles. I love Ashley from Climb the Stacks, who has made a return to BookTube of late. I loved her critical analysis of reading. And I also love Rincey at Rincey Reads. She reads widely and just had a lovely presentation. And so those two make me feel a little fuzzy because they're the first two that I've really watched out of BookTube. And then there are the two people, particularly two people, but more than two people, really, who I'd like to be them when I grow up. I'd like to emulate the way that they review books, similar to Ashley, I guess, from Climb the Stacks. Two other people are Olive from A Book Olive and Janet, insert literary pun here. I just love the way that they critique books. And while I still want to be myself in the way I critique books, I want to be more like them, too, and take inspiration from their critical analyses. Also Kendra Winchester. I think Kendra's taste is a lot like mine. I mean, it's sort of, if I could pay more attention to front lists than I do, because I also do read other stuff, I guess, her interest in literary lady literature, that's where I go to. I always love watching her channel and seeing what she's gushing about, and I've been listening to her podcast, the Reading Women podcast with Autumn, more lately, and I've been thinking I might make a video where I review the winners of their Reading Women Awards from the last 2 years. I thought that would be really fun. Also, there's Juan at Just Juan Reader. I particularly love his wonderful musical tags. He has a beautiful voice, and it's been making me think that I'd kind of like to make a tag for Fiddler on the Roof. Although, personally, I've been singing in choirs all my life, but I'm more of a chorus girl than a soloist, but maybe we can make do. Then there's Katie at Books and Things. Her enthusiasm for Victorian literature is just so infectious. It's just amazing to watch her. It's just so much fun. It just, she brings the love of reading really to life. I thought I'd also take a quick veer into my favorite genre fiction, science fiction and fantasy. Of course, I watch Thomas at FFF180. He packages his content in such a way that it's really nice and accessible for any sort of science fiction and fantasy fan. I love his reviews. They're so funny and to the point. I love seeing what he gets in the mail. And I also want to highlight two science fiction ladies who I love listening to their reviews. I am always interested in their tastes and how they review books. Elizabeth at Books and Pieces and Rachel at Kalanadi. And speaking of genre fiction, Peg at Book Reviews from Peg. She's been reviewing a lot of mystery and crime and things that I don't know much about. But I love her enthusiasm. And I also know, in a non-stalkery way, I know that she lives near me because she commented saying that on my National Book Festival vlog that I did in September. So it's always exciting to think there's a BookTuber who's nearby, and maybe we could meet up at a bookish event. She expressed interest in going to next year's National Book Festival, and I'll be there. And then there's Jen at Remembered Reads. I've loved getting your comments recently in my videos, and I love your videos. You read so widely, and I always am interested in your reading wrap-ups. And finally, there's Frida the Puppy over at some guy's channel who tends to rant about books all the time or something. You know, who knows, but cute puppy. Question 5 is, how long do you spend getting ready every day? Which I think we've taken in this to specifically mean getting ready to do BookTube, and it depends on the video. Like for this one, I had to write out the questions and think about the answers, and I also do scripts sometimes, and so that takes I guess usually between half an hour to an hour, I guess. Then sometimes, like for book hauls and for AM reading updates and wrap-ups and that sort of thing, I tend to just grab the books and just go. So those are a bit quicker. Question 6 is, what is one thing you are most excited about in the coming year? For BookTube, you know, we're coming upon the new year and the whole idea of bookish resolutions. And in fact, I made a long list in my last literary newsletter of my bookish resolutions for 2018. And one of them is that I'm making 2018 a pretty big nonfiction year, at least big for me. A couple of years ago, I started reviewing books that won or were nominated for the Sammy Rohr Prize, which is a prize for emerging Jewish authors, and they alternate every year between fiction and nonfiction. And I started with fiction, and I wrapped up all of the fiction years this year. then I decided, you know what? It's silly for me not to do the nonfiction. I'm very interested in Jewish history and in Jewish culture, and I'd like to widen my reading a little bit and get more into reading nonfiction. So next year, I'm dedicating several months to reading nonfiction titles from all of the nonfiction years, including 2018, which will be a year when they're judging nonfiction. And so my plan is to read 3 books per month of these nonfiction titles and to do reviews on BookTube. So I'm excited about where this will take me and to have conversations with nonfiction lovers on my channel, hopefully. Number 7 is, what is your most awkward filming moment? I don't have funny, awkward filming moments. What I edit out mostly is a bunch of either jumbled words or awkward silences. The most could be, like, you know, an embarrassing burp or something to put it out there. But, you know, nothing too funny. Like, I don't have funny bloopers to show, really. So I thought I'd go back way into yesteryear. In 2009, I was part of a NaNoWriMo Vidler community. Vidler was a platform that I think wanted to compete with YouTube, and of course, you know, didn't go anywhere. But for a while, there was a NaNoWriMo community on Vidler, and we made videos during November. And one of the videos I made in 2009 was a parody of a very popular video at that time from a big YouTube personality, Chris Crocker. He got very emotional about Britney Spears and did this very famous Leave Britney Alone sort of dramatic rendering. And it spawned several parody responses about Leave X Alone. And so I did one for Thanksgiving-themed, U.S. Thanksgiving-themed, which was Leave Nano Alone. And I did a tiny bit of a script, and I was at home with my parents, and I, like, snuck into my room, and I was, like, shouting and crying at the camera, "Leave Nano alone!" And near the end of it, my mother was hearing me, like, have a conniption fit upstairs. She's like, "What's going on? What is up happening with you?" And I think I overacted a bit, or maybe I'm not a good enough parody actor, because I think people on the Vidler community were also not understanding that I was doing a parody. They thought I was actually upset about Thanksgiving. So, but anyway, I moved a lot of those videos over to YouTube when I started my BookTube channel, so I'll link to that down below too. Question 8 is, how are you dressed? We believe this started as a tag for the BookTube beauty community. And what do you know, I had a sort of appearance-based thing happen to me today. I'm wearing this long-sleeved flowery shirt, and underneath I have a black t-shirt, and I have on slacks. I don't actually usually wear this to work. It's more of a weekend outfit for me, but today I wore it to work, and a colleague stopped me on the way to lunch and said, "You look really good." And, I mean, I was flattered, but I also thought to myself, "Oh my God," in that self-absorbed sort of way, "this isn't what I usually wear to work. I don't usually get these sort of comments. Maybe I should be, like, getting rid of some work outfits and buying more stuff like this. And I really do like how this looks on me, too." So what do you know? I don't think I'm made for, like, going out in public. I'd rather just win the lottery and stay at home in my pajamas and read. Question 9 is, what are you most proud of in your life? Well, when it comes to BookTube, I'm proud of how it's contributed to my reading and how much more I'm reading now than I was a few years ago and how much more I'm getting out of books. And I also love that this is offering me a community of critical readers and people who get a lot of enjoyment out of reading a variety of things. I just love that reading has become a huge part of my life and what I get entertainment-wise and critically out of my life now. I love that. And similarly with AuthorTube, I make a few AuthorTube videos, and with NaNoWriMo last month I did a lot of vlogging, and that's contributed to me getting more back into the hobby horse, into writing, and to getting my projects finished. And so I just love that there are these sort of communities out there that can help people connect to that sort of thing. Question 10 is, what makes talking in front of the camera comfortable for you? And honestly, I'm not always sure I am comfortable talking in front of the camera. I was doing actually a lot of bumbling around on that last question. I guess I should have scripted that answer after all. I think something that speaks to me about speaking to the camera is having a passion for books and a passion for writing, and wanting to share that with the world, and wanting to get that out of myself. So that's what compels me because of wanting to be part of something. Question 11 is, what is your worst filming habit? When it comes to filming, I am very amateur and I do not put nearly as much effort into these things as so many other people with their lighting and so forth and their fancy software. Right now, something that's sticking out to me is how I don't do anything for light balance. And oftentimes, when I'm watching these videos, especially when I like lean in close with a book and then lean back, I feel like my lighting is like this yellow psychedelic haze. And I could probably try to do better with maintaining a steady lighting that looks good. Who knows, maybe just by default of being on BookTube so long, I'll be a better filmer. I'm certainly in a much better place than I was a year ago when I was using the webcam, so. And finally, question number 12 is, who do you tag? So I'm going to go with Shawn the Book Maniac because I believe that we are subscribed to each other. And we actually, I don't believe, have communicated as of yet, but I thought, well, why not use a tag to communicate and say, hey, I know you're interested in tags. You do a lot of great ones. Speaking of your tags, I love the page 112 tag, and I'm thinking of doing that for my own purposes starting next year because my TBR is starting to frighten me a little bit. It's a little overwhelming. So I thought for some of my books I might pitch two books against each other with the page 112 tag and choose between them. So, but it's a great tag. I just love how people respond to what they're reading and what they take out of it. And yeah, it's great. And if you're interested in other tags, I tag you here. And that about covers it for me. As usual, tag videos take a lot longer than I thought they would, so I should go now. I should buy more flowery tops and black undershirts, or maybe I should read a bit before bed, or maybe I should just go to sleep. So anyway, thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.